Hey guys, it's Isabel here again, and today I'm going to be reacting to Camila's I Have Questions. Yesterday I did Crying in the Club, which was absolutely amazing, and I'm sure that this is going to be amazing too. So, without further ado, let's get started! Oh boy, this is gonna be emotional. God, it's like 9 o'clock in the morning.
Did you leave me here to burn? Way too young to be this hurt.
Ooh! Wow. I love how she started the song with like tears in her eyes, and the very first lyric is why. I think that you can feel the emotion without even looking at this video. Oh, I have 5 iMessages. This is why I hate being in group chats. I'll put that over there. I love the emotion that you can feel without even looking at the music video. Like, I can just feel in her voice, like the cracking in her voice. Like, a lot of people don't like that, but like, I love that. I think it's very authentic and vulnerable. And I think she's already telling a story. It's literally been like 2 lyrics, and I'm really feeling this.
I feel doomed in hotel rooms, staring straight up at the wall.
She said that she wrote this song in hotel rooms. And you know, a lot of people, I feel like they think that all famous people have it so good. You know, they're rich, they have access to basically everything, and they have a bunch of rich friends, they're all celebrities, and everything's so cool. But in reality, I feel like more than half of artists out there are hurt. Yeah, they might be rich, but if you're rich, but you don't have people to spend it with, then being rich means nothing. Having money does not equal to happiness. I feel like that's one of the biggest misconceptions of famous people. Like, just because you're famous means that you're automatically happy. And if you're not happy, then you're being selfish, because everyone else would wish that they could be famous, but you're over here complaining. But to me, honestly, I really feel for celebrities. Like, I'm a celebrity fanatic. Like, I stan everyone, basically. But like, I just think it's one of those things where people really need to realize, like, it's hard, especially for Camila. Like, all the Fifth Harmony girls, you know, they got into this when they were really young, like 15. And it's one of those things where, like, at the beginning, it sounds amazing. Like, everybody would love to be famous. Until you're famous, though, I think once you're in it, it's kind of hard to get out, because there's so many good things about it, but there's also a lot of bad, you know? There's criticism all the time. I've seen some terrible things said about Camila, and it disgusts me that people are like that, but I think that people really need to give her a break and just, like, let her open up and tell her story. You know, there's 2 sides of every single story out there, and I think that she deserves to tell her side of it. So, let's continue. Wow. Wow. What was that lyric again? I was there when no one else was, and now you're gone, but I am here. That is an amazing lyric. I really hope she came up with this, because this is amazing. That is a very relatable line, you know? You're always there for somebody, you're always there to talk to them, talk them through things. But then all of a sudden, when you need somebody, they're never there for you. They're never there like you are for them. And it's, like, honestly, like, one of the worst feelings ever. And I feel like so far this song kind of sounds like it's for a particular person or a group of people. But I love songs that, like, to her, it probably is for somebody. But she also made it universal so that everybody can relate to it. And that's one thing that I love about music, that the artist probably made this song coming from a personal relationship or a personal thing that happened to them, but they make it universal so that everybody else can relate. And I think that that's so important in music. I love this so far.
I think you are, you got some love.
singing. Shawty's showing off them vocals. Let's go. Shout out to all the people who think that she can't sing. Did you just hear that? Let me play that again for anybody who thinks that she can't sing. Let's rewind. Girl, she's so talented, and I really wish people would stop saying that she can't sing, because that's just ridiculous. I mean, come on now. I think that that's, like, super, super, super ridiculous. She's so talented that, you know, she kind of reminds me of, I don't know how to say her last name. I think it's Bibi Borelli. She kind of reminds me of her a lot. Well, like in the song, at least. I think, like, the tone of her voice kind of reminds me of her. I don't know. I thought this... Wow. This is... wow. I can't even tell. Me, I have questions. I got questions haunting me. That, I love that. I really do. You know? I think that they... Fifth Harmony kind of really did them dirty. With the whole, all my representatives, according to my representatives or whatever. I don't know what all that was about. I mean, I'm sure it was management that wrote that, but honestly, if this is for the girls, I think that, I don't know. I feel like everybody could realize that things were kind of off in the group between her and the rest of the girls. And I think a lot of things were forced, and it was so obvious that it was forced to the point where it just made everybody feel super uncomfortable. And I think that people have been very cruel to her, honestly. And it makes me sad. I'm not blaming the girls for anything. I'm just saying, I don't know. I feel like people are really mean on the internet lately. And it's a sad world. I mean, this world is pretty awful right now. I mean, I'm not gonna go into politics, but I think you know where I'm coming from. I don't know. I really respect this side of her, and I love this, and this really showcases her vocal ability and her songwriting skills. I think the lyrics in this were so beautiful. This was only 1 minute and 42 seconds, so hopefully we get the full song, because I hope it's not that short. Yeah, I would give this a 9 out of 10. I really like this. I really, really do, and I think this album's going to be amazing. I just watched an interview of hers that she did with JoJo Wright, and she said that the album's coming out in September, so I'm very excited. It's kind of a long wait, but I think it's going to be worth it. So yeah, I give this a 9 out of 10. Let me know down below what you guys thought. Yeah, I feel bad for her, and I really wish, I hope that she finds herself. And she really deserves all the happiness in the world. She's one of the sweetest people I've ever met in my life. So down to earth. And it's all real and authentic. It's not fake. Like, there's many celebrities out there who play nice because there's cameras around. But, like, I feel like she's the exact same person on camera and off camera. So, and that's somebody that I really look up to. I don't like when people are fake behind a camera. And not even celebrities. There's people in the real world like that, and it sucks. But, yeah, let me know what you guys thought. Thank you for watching again. And you could also watch my Crying in the Club reaction. I low-key can't even believe that's the song title. When I say that out loud, it makes me laugh. But you can watch that reaction down below. I'll put the link in the description. And yeah, thanks for watching. Let me know if you have any other suggestions of things for me to react to. I would love to do it. I'm not busy today, so maybe I'll do one right after this. But yeah, thank you so much. Peace!